Good morning. Good morning. We see today we see about management by objectives. What is mean by management by objectives? It was given by Peter Drucker in the year of 1954. Management by objectives is also known as management by planning. In these practices, it is one of the main things of planning. Okay. So. We already see it was given by Peter Drucker in the year of 1954. It is a concept of planning. It helps to accomplish our objectives through all the participation of concerned people. So it helps to accomplish their objectives easily with the help of all the participants, all the workers. Okay. Another one is it is a participative one and a democratic style of management. MBO it helps to involve each and every workers to do work effectively, and it is a democratic style of management. We all know about democratic style of management. It means nothing to participation of everyone in work. So it's from superior and subordinate participations. Okay, mom. Okay. So it is a superior and subordinated participations and joint goal settings. Yeah. Even superior means employer and the employees. They jointly define their goals to work effectively, to join their goal setting. Also, second one is goal setting, joint goal settings. Another one is support and encouragement from superiors. Yeah, proper support and recognition from top management. Supporting from top management. In SMART way of method, it is clearly defined about our goals with the help of MBO and it's a concept from specific, measurable and achievable, relevant and time bound. Okay. So what are the process of MBO? Process of MBO is, first one is define our organizational goals. So for most important point is to defining our organizational goals and defining the employees objectives also. First we have to clearly define about our common goals and have to derive our individual goals to connect into common goals. Okay. Another one is continuous monitoring the employees' performance and process. Two, continually watching the employees' activities or behavior in work. So another after thing is to evaluating the performance. If there are any changes or any deviation from our planning to planning and actual performance, to evaluating the performance. What are the deviations between plan and performance? So another one is feedback. If there are any changes or any deviations, providing a proper feedback to correct the work. So another one is performance appraisal. Performance appraisal means after checking everything, we have to encourage or appreciating their employees through the monetary or non-monetary way of motivations. So our next topic is futures of MBO. Futures of MBO is nothing but what are the futures means? It is from superior and subordinate for participations. Yeah, we have to first foremost goal setting is to define a common goal and individual goals to formulate each and every goal settings. They jointly connect the goals to achieve the activities, to achieve the target. So it is a superior and subordinated participation, and it completely depends upon the jointly goal settings and also clarity of goals. Providing a proper information about our goals, what are the needed activities to achieve their work. So it is a clarity of goals and then better communication between coordinators. Better communication between top management and to up up to the level of the lower management people also. So better communication and coordination is for most important for future of MBO. Another one is joint. If we already see joint goal setting also, second point, and fifth point said joint decision making or methodology. Yeah, joint goal setting also give a better way to make a joint decision making also. And make a way to attain a maximum result. Yeah, using a minimum cost to attain a maximum output. So it is a better way to maintaining a maximum result also. And then after that achievement, proper support from top management also, giving a proper recognition or appreciations or a salary improvement, salary increasement for top management. So it is, these are the futures of MBO. What are the steps in MBO? First one is setting organizational purpose and objectives. First we have to formulate our organizational purpose and objectives and giving a and to formulate a key result area. What are the key result area or what are the main area to focus quickly to attain our target? So defining a key resulted area and setting a subordinate objectives to giving or providing a each and every individual who assigning work. So setting a subordinate objectives. Another one is matching resources with objectives. After formulating or after setting a subordinate objectives, these are the matching with resources with objectives also. And another one is appraisal. Appraisal means it's a main things to giving a proper appraisal for proper or periodical appraisal for everyone. Another one is recycling. Recycling means it helps to reduce the wastages also. Thank you. Thank you. Today we see about what is meant by MBO. Okay, it is clear.